So we're actually going to explore this idea of labels that a mandatory access control policy would use in a DoD, Department of Defense kind of environment, a little bit more by looking at some examples. So information is going to have classification, and users are going to have clearances. Okay, so the highest sensitivity typically is top secret. That's the innermost one. Then secret, confidential, and going out, we have this unclassified. We said, you know, this information anyone can see. So most sensitive, least sensitive. This is, we said, the level at which somebody is cleared or the classification level of a document. So we said label is going to be a sensitivity level. So for example, it could be top secret here. And a compartment that describes what kind of data is contained in the document. So we're going to, let's say, look at documents, one that is top secret. And let's say these documents have information about various arms stockpiles. So this document, let's say, talks about nuclear and chemical weapons. You hear about them in the news. So, you know, this is clearly extremely sensitive. So we're going to say that is top secret, and the document contains information about both nuclear and chemical weapons. We have another document that has information about, let's say, conventional. So maybe it's sensitive, but just a notch below. So let's say this is only secret. So we have two labels here, L1. L1 sensitivity level is TS, comma, the compartment is nuclear, comma, chemical. Remember, this compartment here looks like a set. Okay, so the document may pertain to multiple topics or areas. So each one of them could be in this, and that's the description of that document using the set of terms that we have here. So L1 is TS, comma, nuclear, chemical. L2 is secret S, comma, nuclear, conventional. Using these labels, L1 and L2, we're actually going to be able to decide. Access control in the end comes to being able to read and write documents, because that's what you do to files or documents. So we actually, you know, when disclosure or confidentiality is an issue, there is a model, Bell and LaPadula model or BLP model, that makes use of labels exactly like the L1 and L2 that we have here. And actually the model is defined by a set of rules that tell you when, based on these labels, you can read or write. But implementation of mandatory access control is always going to require some kind of labels.